Thank you, Lacey. Starting today and for the next 3 or 4 weeks, we're going to have a different person share with you why they give, why they support Mosaic. And I'm also going to have some flyers to pass out for you to look at, to think about what our church does. Just take one and pass them back. To think about what our church is about, who we are, what our future looks like, and then how you might play a role in that and how you might support the church next year. Today, I've invited Kay to come and speak, and Kay is somebody who, it occurred to me just now, has had a job, profession, out in the world. I think God used her in that profession, but she's also someone who's used her gifts, her skills, her passion, her talents for God through the church as well. So Kay, if you'd come and share with us.
Yes, he asked me to make a statement about why I give and support Mosaic. Let me take this off. So I think my consideration had to do more with Mosaic. I mean, had to do with more than Mosaic, but it also includes Mosaic. The first reason that I give is that you're supposed to. I know you're supposed to because my daddy said so. My daddy was a preacher, and he preached and taught and modeled tithing, giving a tithe of his income. It was a biblical standard of giving. At one point, daddy gave me a $5 a month for dusting his study, but he said, "You don't need to tithe that. It's already been tithed." I think he missed an important lesson for me, but anyway, that's all right. I give because I'm grateful to God. God has sustained me through the giving of my church and church friends in many ways, from scholarships to school to college to home repair, and I have a wonderful story to tell you about that in a minute. But there are other times of help and guidance and gifts from God through my church friends. In 1999, I received a mandate from the city that my house needed to be painted and have some repair work done. And there was no way I had the money to do that. And I had no idea what I was going to do. And while I was fretting and stewing about that, I was talking about it with some friends at the church. And one of the ladies, who is no longer a part of this community, said, "This sounds like a mission to me, a mission for Clegg Church." And so from March, I believe, I don't have my dates exactly, from March through August, every Saturday, there was a group of individuals who came and worked on my house. They removed 8 layers of shingles and filled a whole dumpster with all of that, and then repaired the house, the shingles, re-shingled the house, and did other work, and then painted it. It was a wonderful gift, and there have been other times when people from the church have helped with problems I've had with my house. I view this as God providing for me through my church. I give because I love what my money can help to accomplish in the world beyond what my income could do. When I see panhandlers on the street, I know that some of the money I give to Mosaic goes to Skyline to help people who are in need and goes in other places. When I hear of natural disasters in Moore, Oklahoma, or Haiti, or Nepal, I know that some of the money that I give through the church goes to Church World Service, which is present in natural disasters all around the globe and other catastrophes around the globe. And they stay there from the beginning, long past the time when other agencies are there trying to help stabilize the community and the work that has been done. And last of all, I give because I love the mission statement of Mosaic. I want to help support Mosaic and be a part of what we do and be a part of what we say at the end of the service. If I give, my church can be generous, and I want to practice all the things I want my church to be.